They didn't believe you could change politics as usual in Massachusetts. Well, they're not laughing anymore. They're worried, and they're responding just as you'd expect, with misleading negative ads. All I've said on taxes is the truth. If we cut the income tax now, your property taxes will go up. It's a shell game, and we can't afford it. Insider politics and negative ads won't lift our state, but on Election Day, we can.
Marshall's Law of Fall Fashion, number 132. Put your foot down on high heel prices. Number 43. It's not just who you're wearing, it's what you paid for who you're wearing. Right now, get the same fabulous designer and brand names you see in those fashion magazines for up to half off department store prices. So why pay more? Number 67. Fill up your closet without emptying your purse. That's Marshall's Law.
Seven's chief meteorologist, Pete Bouchard. Weather just got better.
Good morning. Raging infernos. Firefighters out west battling huge wildfires that have been burning for weeks, capping off the worst fire season in half a century. Why did she do it? An exclusive interview with the former school teacher who admitted to having sex with a 14-year-old student.
Yeah, he wanted it. And, yeah, I gave it to him.
This morning, Deborah LaFave tells all.
It's a new day.
And, yes, it is a new day. Meredith Vieira is up bright and early, and she's officially joining our family today, Wednesday, September 13th, 2006.
From NBC News, this is Today with Matt Lauer and Meredith Vieira, live from Studio 1A in Rockefeller Plaza.
And good morning, everyone, and welcome to a very, very special Wednesday morning. I'm Matt Lauer, and I couldn't be happier than to welcome the woman who is sitting next to me to our family and to our team. Meredith Vieira is here, and it's great to have you here.
I feel like it's the first day of school, and I'm sitting next to the cutest guy, you know, in the class. That's you.
And you can stay.
How are you doing? I'm doing great. I was so nervous last night, and my kids are watching now, my husband, but they have to go to school. The kids do. Husband has to go to work. And last night, they gave me a takeout dinner of Chinese food, and they gave me this bracelet because they saw how nervous I was, and it says, "We are with you. Love, Richard, Ben, Gabe, and Lily." Isn't that sweet? So happy. I can't tell you. I'm so excited.
I have not been more excited to come to work since the day after Bryant announced he was leaving. This is really big. And by the way, it's a little bit of a tradition here at the Today Show. Bryant did it for Katie, and Katie did it for me, and I want to do it for you. Can we play that one more time and just listen?
So far, we're right on. Yeah.
And Meredith Vieira.
Live from
Studio 1A in Rockefeller Plaza.
You like the way it sounds?
I do, but it's still Matt Lauer and Meredith.
Meredith Vieira.
I don't think that's going to change.
No, I know. They told me.
Unless you bump me off.
No.
Anyway, we're going to have some fun today.
I'm going to be the broad in broadcasting, okay?
No, don't do that. We're going to have some fun. We've got some surprises on tap for you, but also we've got some news to get to, so we'll put you right to work.
Absolutely. Okay, Matt, coming up, we'll get the latest on the efforts to battle those big wildfires burning out west. Fire officials say more than 8.5 million acres have burned this summer. That's an area bigger than the entire state of Maryland. Meanwhile, the heat's on in Washington, D.C. as well, with Democrats and Republicans sniping over who's stronger on national security. The Democrats are still furious over the president's 9/11 speech. We'll get into the brouhaha in just a little while.
And we're going to have that exclusive interview with Deborah LaFave, the former teacher who admitted to having sex with a middle school student. And we'll also say goodbye to one more wedding couple this morning before the remaining two couples then face off in a food fight kind of a la the Iron Chef. But first, we want you to take a quick look around because Meredith is a new arrival, but we also have another new arrival. We've got a brand spanking new studio. And by the way, if you have a high-definition television at home, it's a new day for you as well. We're going to explain that and take you on a little bit of a tour a little later on.
High-def is dangerous.
Yeah.
You know?
I was going to come in like this morning. Before we go any further, let's go over to the news desk. Ann's got the headlines of the morning. Ann?
Matt and Meredith, good morning and welcome, Meredith.
Thanks,
good morning, everybody. In the news this morning, we begin with news from Baghdad, where police found the bodies of 65 men in mostly Sunni neighborhoods, and they had been tortured. There were also car bombs and mortar attacks in and around Baghdad today. At least 32 civilians died, and at least two U.S. soldiers have been killed since Monday. Meantime, today, the man in charge of prosecuting Saddam Hussein accused the judge of bias and demanded that he step down. He shouted that the judge was letting Saddam make political statements in court that were inappropriate to the proceedings. A senator who voted against the war in Iraq won a tough primary fight on Tuesday. Republican Senator Lincoln Chafee, a moderate, beat a conservative challenger in Rhode Island. The race was closely watched as the nation heads toward the November elections. Tropical Storm Gordon grew into a hurricane during the night. It's the third hurricane of the season. The forecasters say there is no threat to land. Firefighters are still struggling with a dangerous wildfire north of Los Angeles. The fire is fast moving, so far burning more than 37 square miles in the Los Padres National Forest. Parents well know how hard it is to know what to do when their young children get ear infections. Well, doctors now are changing their advice, suggesting parents put off using antibiotics. NBC's chief science correspondent Robert Bazell reports now.
Okay, you can go in there with your dad.
Parents bring children to the doctors 16 million times a year for ear infections.
Does your ear hurt?
Until recently, the doctor almost always wrote a prescription for antibiotics. The antibiotics usually cure the infection, but using so much of them is causing a big problem, the emergence of super germs resistant to antibiotics. So many doctors are trying a new approach called wait and see. They ask the parents to wait a day or two to fill out the antibiotic prescription. The new study compared that approach with giving the antibiotics right away. The study found that the children in the wait and see program did just as well, and they used 56% fewer antibiotics. Even though the research shows the plan works, it can be tough for parents like Renee Dustman.
However, as a parent, my first priority is making sure that my child is pain-free and not having sleepless nights and pain.
But the new study shows, as difficult as it can be for parents, the infection often gets better without antibiotics. Robert Bazell, NBC News, San Francisco.
There were some frightening moments last night on a United Airlines flight from Los Angeles to Washington, D.C. A passenger became unruly and tried to open one of the plane's doors in midair. He was subdued by other passengers and the plane landed safely. And astronauts on the International Space Station went for another spacewalk today. They're doing more construction work on a 45-foot addition carried up by the shuttle Atlantis. How cool is that shot? It is now 7:06, and now I get to do this now. This is fun. Now back to Matt, Meredith, and Al.
All right, Ann, thank you very much. You've said hello to Mr. Roker
over to our left. Hello, Al. You know, I'm particularly fond of you because I had a hamster named Al growing up.
Oh, really? But
Big
he died.
Al. He died. Yeah. Yes, he did die.
He went toes up. And he's in a coffee can in your backyard. Okay.
Yeah, he's
well,
I don't know about you. I got goosebumps.
I know. I do, too. Hold on a second. Let me go get my wheel. Yeah. Anyway. Let's take a look, show you what's going on right now. You can see we got airport delays possible from Tampa all the way up to Buffalo. That's thanks to a very vigorous storm system working its way, bringing heavy rain. Some areas going to be picking up as much as 5 inches of rain as you get down just east or west of Tampa on into the panhandle. Rest of the country, beautiful in the Pacific Northwest, some clouds, but temperatures in the 60s. The heat continues in the Southwest. 74 degrees in San Diego, though, a little bit cooler after some morning fog burns off. That's what's going on around the country. Here's what's happening in your neck of the woods.
We do have a mix of clouds and sunshine right now, 54 here in the city, but look at Norwood, much cooler, 41, Plymouth at 44. Today, partly sunny skies. Here's our next weather system. It's not that far away, but the raindrops, I think, will stay out of New England. We'll get the clouds in here this afternoon. Temperatures this afternoon near 70. This evening, a lot of clouds, not as cool. Temperatures drop back into the mid-60s. 7-on-7 forecast, showers tomorrow, and they linger into Friday as well.
That's your latest weather, Matt.
All right, Al, thanks so much. On Close Up this morning, the politics of the war on terror. Both Democrats and Republicans promised to try for bipartisanship after 9/11, but 5 years later, many in Congress are at war with each other. NBC's chief White House correspondent David Gregory has more on that. David, good morning to you.
Good morning to you, Matt. And yeah, the politics of national security have become so divisive in Washington during this election year that even the president's 9/11 address in prime time to the country has ignited an emotionally charged debate. The president may have thought he could use 9/11 to heal political wounds.
We must put aside our differences and work together to meet the test that history has given us.
But Democrats considered it an empty gesture, one more political argument disguised as a commemorative speech in an increasingly bitter campaign season. They are now requesting equal time on the television networks to respond.
This was a political move. designed to tap the overwhelming public sentiment to destroy al-Qaeda as a way to bolster sagging public opinion support for the war in Iraq.
The president's speech echoed the argument he's been making in a series of false speeches.
I'm often asked why we're in Iraq when Saddam Hussein was not responsible for the 9/11 attacks. The answer is that the regime of Saddam Hussein was a clear threat.
But the White House insisted the reference to Iraq was appropriate.
We are in Iraq. It is now seen as the central focal point of the war on terror by the very people who mounted September 11th.
The primetime address, as in part political argument, comes as Republicans are unleashing pointed attacks against Democrats, hoping to leave the impression they are weak in the face of terror. The vice president on Meet the Press Sunday.
Suggestions, for example, that we should withdraw U.S. forces from Iraq simply feed into that whole notion, validates the strategy of the terrorists.
The House Republican leader John Boehner added this about Democrats Tuesday, quote, I wonder if they are more interested in protecting the terrorists than they are in protecting the American people. But it is Iraq that Democrats will use to undermine those Republican arguments and neutralize a national security advantage the president has used successfully against Democrats in two elections since 9/11.
Iraq has certainly made a dent on the image of George Bush as someone who was a flawless defender of the country in national security. It has made it easier to criticize him in foreign policy.
And that criticism has come. So the big question now, over the next 55 days until Election Day, is our voters more frustrated with the president's handling of the war in Iraq than they are afraid of change in Washington? Meredith, back to you.
Thank you, David Gregory. Tim Russett is NBC's Washington Bureau Chief and moderator of Meet the Press. Tim, good morning.
Great to be here. Welcome.
Thank you so much. I want to go back to the president's speech on Monday night because the Democrats are furious. They say that he took advantage of a very solemn occasion in this country to push his agenda about the war in Iraq and tie it to the greater war on terror. Do you think that the president overplayed his hand, or was the administration hoping that the Democrats would respond exactly the way that they did?
A little bit of both. The president clearly engaged the country in remembering those who died on September 11th, talked about al-Qaeda, the war on terror, and then played the Iraq card. And that's why the Democrats are so furious. Because, Meredith, it comes down to this. The president saying Iraq is a central front on the war on terror, the Democrats saying it's a distraction. That's the debate we're having. And the president very much played into that in his speech. The Democrats seized on it, and now both sides are seeking advantage.
Well, there was a recent poll where Americans were asked, do you believe that the war of Iraq is part of the war on terror? And 53% of Americans, the majority, said they did not believe it was. So is this then a boost for the Democrats, or do you think that the president can regain public support for the war?
That's something that troubles the White House. If they lose the battle over Iraq in terms of the public consciousness, whether it is part of the war on terror, then they can lose this midterm election. That's why this president is going around the country giving these speeches. That's why he invoked it in the primetime speech. And that's why the Democrats are trying so vigorously to pry away Iraq from the war on terror.
Meanwhile, you have, as David Gregory pointed out, the House Speaker saying, criticizing the Democrats for criticizing the president by saying that they're really soft on terrorism, that their commitment to fighting the war is not really there. That's worked effectively for the Republicans in the past, that argument. Do you think that it still will work?
The words that Congressman Boehner used, almost suggesting the Democrats are aligning themselves with the terrorists, really sent shockwaves through Washington. And the White House, when asked and pressed by David Gregory, does the president agree with that, said no. It's a very fine line. You can accuse people of not being vigorous or strong on national defense and national security, but when you start suggesting that they are closer to the terrorists than they are to protecting the American people, I think people in both parties think that crossed the line.
Meanwhile, a lot of people are wondering about the Democrats. They've argued against the Republican position for months now, but they really haven't come up with a plan of their own when it comes to victory in Iraq without withdrawing. Do they need a plan, do you think, heading into these elections?
That's the magical question. You have put your finger on it. Is it enough to say we're against George Bush? Stay the course is not the right policy. We need a new direction. Will the American people say, what is that direction? 60% of the American people now believe the war in Iraq is not worth it, but they don't want to withdraw immediately. They don't like the war, but they don't want to leave a bigger mess behind. And the Democrats have yet been able to chart a course that gives people saying, oh, now I see where you want to take us. Between now and the election, I do think the Democrats are going to have to be more specific so the American people say, yes, We'll make a change, and you have a viable alternative.
But boy, that is not a lot of time to come up with a new plan.
Well, not at all, and the Democrats are very, very divided. 18 Democrats say that we should cut off funding. Some Democrats say we should redeploy. Some say we should withdraw. Some say we should have a phase withdrawal. It's very, very difficult. It's very complicated. You know why? Because it's a mess. Both sides will acknowledge it's a mess.
Meantime, we have these elections coming up. Use your crystal ball. Who do you think will control the House and the Senate? Right now, the Republicans do, when all the votes are cast in November.
I've talked to so many Democrats and Republicans yesterday because I had a sense that you might ask me this question on your first day.
Because I know you're a genius.
No, but what they say is that election held today, the Democrats would probably capture the House, Republicans would probably hold the Senate. Why is that important? If one party takes over one part House of government, suddenly there's hearings, investigations, oversight, all the cabinet officials, White House officials before Congress, what about Iraq, what about weapons of mass destruction, what about Katrina, and then changes on health care or minimum wage, those kinds of things. The question is, the Democrats will make gains. Will they have enough to seize control of the House? It's a long 8 weeks away. I think the events on the ground in Iraq will affect this election more than any other speech or any other political posturing.
Tim Russert, thank you very much. We'll be coming to you a lot in the next few weeks. Now it is 7:15, and here is Matt.
All right, Meredith, Tim, thanks very much. This morning on Today at the Pump, we've got some encouraging news to report for a change. We're talking about the falling price of gasoline. At the height of the summer driving season just last month, gas prices peaked for the year at $3.04 a gallon. Now the national average of regular unleaded is back down to a much more reasonable $2.59 a gallon. That's according to the AAA. In some places, that price is even a little bit lower. Take a quick look at the prices we found Tuesday around the country. And among the people paying the least for gas, motorists in Ohio, where gas was $2.31. Missouri, where drivers are spending just a penny more than that. So the question is, why the drop? Well, experts say some of the factors include strong domestic production, increased imports, a relatively quiet hurricane season so far, that's good news, and of course, demand at this time of the year going down now as well. Of course, not everyone is getting relief. In the West, Idaho's average was $2.97 a gallon. In Nevada, $2.96. California, $2.95. But they may still get a break because AAA expects prices to continue to fall an additional 10 cents during the next several weeks. So some mixed news there. It's now 16 minutes after the hour. Once again, here's Meredith.
Okay, Matt, thanks. There is a knockdown, drag-out fight taking place in Los Angeles these days, but it is not feuding movie stars going head-to-head. The combatants, a trendy boutique, and a celebrity magazine. Here's NBC's Peter Alexander.
In Hollywood, where the stars shop is just as important as what the stars wear. Celebrity magazines are peppered with photos of the rich and famous with shopping bags in hand. Paris Hilton, Lindsay Lohan, Jessica Simpson.
Every time a celebrity walks out of a store, it seems like there's a camera waiting. Mine should be here any moment. Each shot can be worth tens of thousands of dollars to the paparazzi, to the magazine, and yes, to the store.
But did you ever wonder how the paparazzi know where the stars are shopping to get that money shot? It's no coincidence. For the stores, it's big business.
There's a store owner that wants to give us a heads up because they want some publicity in their store or a restaurant. One hand greases the other, and you know, we're all part of a big entertainment wheel that help each other out.
But one of LA's hippest hotspots is complaining that wheel just stopped. Kitson, a boutique favored by the stars, is now suing Us Weekly, a magazine all about stars. The store isn't upset by what the magazine is writing about them, but that Us Weekly isn't writing about them at all. Barely a single mention in months, they claim, not even in captions as the magazines normally would. Kitson's owner says it's costing him $10,000 a week. Us Weekly calls the lawsuit frivolous and completely without merit. It's the ultimate in product placement.
Just seeing a picture of a celebrity leaving our shop brings in hundreds of web sales for us. People in from the Midwest, people from other countries, all around the world, just want a little bit of what every celebrity has.
Here in Hollywood, everyone wants a credit. But for now, one store claims it's being left on the cutting room floor. For today, Peter Alexander, NBC News, Hollywood.
Well, while it doesn't appear to be taken anywhere near the store in Los Angeles, there was one photo that caught my eye, and apparently I wasn't the only one. Yep.
For an autograph?
I sure do. Oh, do not start with this. That's just not nice. That's not nice. The amazing thing, they put my head on your body.
That's right, folks. That was the president of the United States of America asking Matt for an autograph on his photo in People magazine right there.
Doesn't he have better things to do than read People magazine?
He's turned on by your abs, honey.
Don't make me go to Esquire from 1988.
Well, picture,
which we could get to later, all right?
Well, that's how far back you have to go for me.
Don't make me go here, okay?
I have clothes on. Hello, Exhibit A.
I have jams on.
Now you do. Will you sign it later?
I certainly will. You ready to say it for the first time?
Yeah, I am.
All right, take it away.
We'll be back in a moment, but first, this is Today on NBC.
We do.
$14,000 jobs. That's how many jobs Andrea Silbert helped create as CEO of the nonprofit Center for Women in Enterprise.
We're going to need both the governor and the lieutenant governor going at full steam to turn our economy around.
Andrea Silbert, a plan to use new jobs revenue to improve our public schools and create more middle-class housing.
Jobs is the issue that pays for everything else.
Andrea Silbert, the jobs candidate for lieutenant governor.
Paid for by the committee to elect Andrea Silbert.
Undeniable power of Panasonic plasma. Nothing compares to America's best-selling plasma TVs. Panasonic, ideas for life.
What are you doing?
Making a sandwich.
Dude, you're making a mistake. Lose this, use this.
What's that?
At Thomas's Square.
With the great taste of a bagel and the softness of bread, Thomas's Square's bagel bread is the best way to make a better sandwich.
What are you doing?
Making a sandwich?
Dude, you're making a mistake. Watch and learn.
Thomas's Square's bagel bread. Part bagel, part bread. Totally delicious.
After all the corporate scandals, Chris Gabrielli and Deval Patrick just don't get it. They each want to be governor, but they won't publicly release their tax returns. Something candidates have routinely done in the past. What are they hiding? Tom Riley thinks elected officials should be held to a higher standard. That's why Riley has made his tax returns public. The Globe praised Riley for his openness and urged Gabrielli and Patrick to follow his example. Unfortunately, they've refused. We deserve better. Tom Riley for governor.
It's a new day all over. It's a new day.
We've got planes flying around Manhattan. We've got leaflets being dropped. We may have the blimp even.
Wait, I thought I was the blimp. That's what you told me.
He's been very nice. Anyway, we've got a little welcome surprises for you throughout the morning.
All right.
And you're through a half hour.
I am. I'm through the first half hour.
That's right. Next half hour, spanking machine.
Wow, now you're talking. Coming up in our next half hour, Matt's exclusive interview with Deborah LaFave, the Florida school teacher who set off 1,000 tabloid headlines for having a sexual relationship with a 14-year-old student.
And Meredith, this is your life from early years in the news trenches to your family life. We'll help get to know you a little more. But first, your local news.
Friday on Today, Black Eyed Peas with Fergie. Delicious. In a special performance, live on the Plaza, only on Today on NBC.
There are some things money can't buy. For everything else. For everything else, there's World MasterCard, the card that won't hold you back.
Speak to me in sense. Murmur lavender, and I'll listen. Immerse me in vanilla, and you'll soothe my soul.
Introducing Tide Simple Pleasures, a new laundry detergent for a clean that refreshes and a scent that can relax, so you can pull on a change of mood. Experience new Tide Simple Pleasures in vanilla and lavender, rose and violet, and water lily and jasmine. Matching scents also available in Downy Simple Pleasures.
My allergies can get so bad, I feel like I'm in a fog. But I'm the kind of person who wants to be focused. Now, I'm Claritin Clear. My doctor was the first one to recommend Claritin. It's the only one actually proven to make you as alert and focused as someone without allergies. Claritin relieves my sneezing and itchy eyes without making me drowsy. That one, please. 24-hour non-drowsy Claritin. Live Claritin Clear.
Okay, what's with the phone? You had that out all night.
Oh, it's not just a phone. It takes photos with this little camera, and it also records little video clips.
Yeah, I heard that Silk soy milk can do this. Do that, do the other. Margaret went on and on about the heart health benefits and soy protein. And I said, it's healthy. Listen, I get it. I'll drink it. Okay?
They say it truly exists. So we seek it out. A miracle food that nourishes the mind and body. We call it the egg.
Good news, America. Now, wherever you are, there's a Macy's near you. Macy's, way to shop.
NFL on NBC, and your seat is on 7. Kick off your Sunday night with the biggest game of the week. Then, after 7 news, it's Sports Extra. Your Sunday nights will never be the same.
Who can help get our state moving again?
Deb Goldberg is my choice for getting our public education system back on the right track.
Deb Goldberg is going to really fight for the accountability of these health insurers.
Deb will do all she can to keep jobs in Massachusetts.
She never backs away.
Deb will work hard for this Commonwealth. The state needs a leader like Deb Goldberg.
I'm Deb Goldberg, and I'm running for Lieutenant Governor. Next Tuesday, I'd appreciate your vote.
7 News is brought to you in part by Bernie and Phil's Furniture.
This is 7 News.
Good morning, everybody. 727, and here's Jeremy with your Wednesday forecast. Jeremy?
Krista, a mix of clouds and sunshine today. It's still cool out there right now. Temperatures in the upper 40s. By 2 o'clock this afternoon, clouds are beginning to take over the sky. A dry afternoon. Temperatures around 70, partly cloudy skies this evening. Now for tomorrow, clouds in here. Some showers as well, near 70 tomorrow. A few lingering showers on Friday, and then for the weekend, we clear it out and we begin to warm it up. Look at Sunday, low 80s.
Hazardous materials crews called to the scene of a train derailment in Deerfield. That train jumping the tracks last night with a total of 19 cars derailing. State police say there were no leaks or contamination. Most of the derailed cars were carrying food-grade materials. Also this morning, West Nile virus has been found in a second pool of mosquitoes in Boston. The latest mosquitoes to test positive were collected from the Riverway area. In late August, the virus was found in mosquitoes in West Roxbury. So far this year, there has been one confirmed human case of West Nile, an elderly woman from Arlington. Now back to the Today Show with Matt and Meredith.
Bernie and Phil's has negotiated a special buy on truckloads of beautiful top-grain Italian leather furniture.
Come on in and take advantage of our special purchase values while they last.
Good idea, Bernie. Right now, get a leather sofa, love seat, and chair, or a three-piece leather sectional sofa for just $15.97. And pay nothing for 12 months at Bernie and Phil's. Don't wait. Your special purchase value is available at
Bernie and Phil's. Quality, comfort, and price. That's nice.
My name's Ron Bersani. My granddaughter, Melanie, was killed by a drunk driver. The laws in Massachusetts simply were not tough enough.
When the legislature passed a weak drunk driving law, Carrie Healy said no.
We were fighting a culture in Massachusetts that stymied tougher drunk driving laws.
She fought the legislature and delivered a tougher bill, cracking down on repeat drunk drivers.
We're very proud to have Carrie Healy on our side. When Carrie Healy says she's going to do something, she'll do it.
Yeah, okay, whatever.
So,
do you mind?
Certainly so.
If we can stand up to him, all Europe may be free.
I do have the simplest taste.
You're always satisfied with the best, Mr. Wilde. Oh.
This is a time for serious leadership. We need a governor who will bring people together to try new things. A governor who will tell you where he stands. A governor with concrete ideas to make people's lives a little easier. A governor who's not going to promise everything and deliver nothing. A governor who has a proven track record of getting things done. A governor who's going to hold himself accountable. I'm Chris Gabrielli. It shouldn't matter if an idea is Democratic or Republican, as long as it's a good idea that gets results.
Back now at 7:30 on this Wednesday morning, September 13th, 2006. A cool late summer morning with a cool crowd joining us here in Rockefeller Plaza. Meanwhile, inside the new and improved Studio 1A, I'm Meredith Vieira here with Matt Lauer. And coming up this half hour, aw shucks. All about me.
We just want people to get to know a little bit more about you. Nothing embarrassing, although after the People magazine stunt in the last half hour, I may have to go dig deeper. Anyway, as they say at the dentist, this is not going to hurt a bit. Also ahead, I'll have an exclusive interview with Deborah LaFave, a young woman who became one of the most notorious school teachers in America when she was arrested for having sex with a 14-year-old student. So what drove her to do that, to risk her marriage, her career, and her freedom? This morning, she'll speak out in her first ever television interview.
And then, on a lighter note, the end is coming. We will say goodbye to one of the three final couples competing for the chance to get married live on today. And then the two couples left standing will face off in a cooking competition. I've actually been following it all summer, so I'm looking forward to finally meeting the three
couples. Have you really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good. I'm glad. So we don't have to kind of introduce you to them.
No, I know them. I'm the one who has to tell the one who's going to have to leave goodbye.
We always
I got stuck with that. I don't
believe
that.
That was planned. You get to be the hatchet man on the first day. But first, we all know about Meredith's 9-year career on The View and as her time as host of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. But here's what you don't know about the Emmy Award-winning broadcast. I'm talking about you like you're not even here.
Like I'm dead.
The supermom and my new co-anchor.
I was born December 30th, 1953, oh my God, in Providence, Rhode Island. The baby, with three older brothers, Jeff, Steve, and Edwin. My dad was a general practitioner, family doc, and my mom, Mary Elsie, was a homemaker. As a family, there were certain shows we'd watch. I still like watching Leave It to Beaver. How scary is that? And I remember that monkey on the Today Show. So, you know, I didn't know it was Matt, but I do remember the monkey. My brother Jeffrey, who's a year and 2 months older than me, he couldn't pronounce my name, so he'd say Meredith with a bit of a lisp.
We called her Ditsy or Dits. When I think of our high school years, I think about lying on the grass with our reflectors, desperately trying to get a tan, drinking gallons of tab, listening to the Beatles.
For many years, my pillow was Paul McCartney, I must tell you. And I would hug that pillow. I thought about being a rockette because I was a tap dancer from the time I was little, and I thought, oh, I want to be a rockette. That would be heaven.
Under Meredith's yearbook photo, it says, Tutu LaRue tap dances her way into the hearts of millions. It turns out she will be dancing her way into the hearts of millions on the Today Show, with or without tap shoes.
I was at Tufts University in my senior year and had had pretty much every major you could have. I fell into this career. I never planned to be a journalist, and I was too stupid to say I don't know anything about television, so I said, sure, I'll do that. And next thing I know, I'm doing radio and television down in Providence.
How does the law protect protect your children. The snowman melts at the rate of 1 inch per hour. These boats won't be going anywhere anytime soon.
In fact, at one point, the news director said to me, I don't think you have what it takes to be in this business. And I stormed into his office and I said, well, you may not think I have what it takes, but I know I have what it takes. Approval in both countries is expected. A few weeks later, New York called WCBS Television in New York. And the general manager said, I like her spunk. Good evening, I'm Meredith Vieira.
Whenever I see your smiling face.
When I met Richard, I wouldn't say it was love at first sight.
Contempt at first sight.
I had done a story and I had some downtime and I was in my office literally watching Bugs Bunny, and he made some comment about the state of CBS News with people like me as reporters. And I thought, A, what a jerk. And B, I actually, it crossed my mind, I think I'm going to marry this guy.
I was diagnosed with MS probably about 10 years before I met her. She's a great friend to me. We have a great life.
If you follow my path, it's nothing straight about it. It's all over the map. The outpouring around the world to save the starving in Africa has been extraordinary.
But Anthony is only 9 years old. I wanted you to meet him.
There's a bitter new reality for people with AIDS.
The Harrison presidential dynasty led the country from hoe to hum. I think there was a big controversy when she appeared in Esquire magazine showing some leg about whether a newswoman could be a little flirtatious and sexy and still be truly a news person.
What I can tell you is Newell's policy
does
is not to discriminate.
Does discrimination sound like one of those things it could be?
She's a great broadcaster. She's loaded with sex appeal. She's a first-rate journalist.
All hell broke loose there at 60, and there was just a parting of the ways where I felt I couldn't do that job and be the kind of mom that I wanted to be.
She put it once that her baby was more important than my baby, and it was kind of clever, but it rankled me.
Meredith's been a pioneer in some ways. I mean, she really has been out front on the issue of family, of having kids, of keeping a balance in her life.
Mama mia, here I go again.
I've been married to my husband Richard for 20 years. We have three children. Ben is our oldest. He's 17. Oh my God, yeah, he's 17. Oh my God. He drives now. Gabe is 15 and Lily Max is 13. As a mom, I don't think I call myself a disciplinarian. I talk a good game with my kids, and I think our kids are good, well-grounded. I don't cook for my family very often because they can't stand the way I cook, I mean, to be honest.
She cooks.
My mom's cooking is interesting.
Most of her cooking is lack thereof.
Sometimes I feel I have to actually stand with her by the grill because I get worried that she's gonna pick up a hot pan or burn the food.
Good morning, I'm Meredith Vieira. It is Monday, August 11th, and this is the first day of our brand new show, Call the View. I thought, I'm not gonna, why would I do daytime television? You know, I'm a newswoman. And then my husband Richard is the one who said, well, you're a newswoman who doesn't want to report. He said to me, just try this. And then I became a little bit crazy. Like, talk about ditzy.
Welcome to The View. It's Halloween. Am I the only one who remembered?
People think it's crazy.
I think it's adorable.
Thank you for a wonderful 9 years. I love you.
Oh.
It's hard to say goodbye, but Meredith is going to be wonderful. It's a whole new chapter for her.
I'm most proud of the fact that she never really quit.
She's kept her cool the entire time. And I think we really appreciate how much she does for us.
It's a beautiful morning.
It's an institution. It's part of Americana, and it's so cool to be a part of that.
And just smile.
Ultimately, I just want people to see me as just me, a normal person, trying to get through the day just like they are.
You're gonna make it after all.
That's nice, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, poor Mary Tyler Moore is probably gagging right now. My shot. It was so sweet.
I especially like getting to see your kids and Richard.
They're wise guys, aren't they?
It comes very naturally
exactly,
to you.
Exactly, yeah.
Meanwhile, so that Esquire magazine,
yes.
Boy, it would be great to have a copy of that, wouldn't it?
Okay.
Just happened to have that, the leg shot. You got a little grief for this.
I got a lot of grief from people who thought that a journalist should never pose like that. But my argument was that, yeah, I'm a journalist, yes, but I'm also a woman, and I'm not ashamed of being a woman. Meanwhile, those legs are not quite as good anymore, but what the heck.
What does Tutu LaRue mean?
Because I used to go down to Manny Almeida's. Well, I didn't really go down. There was this bar, Manny Almeida's, right. And I would say that I was one day going to perform on the bar, tap dancing.
As Tutu LaRue?
Yes.
You don't think that name might stick around here? As a matter of fact, let's go to a live shot at the dressing room right now. We've got our crack staff already in business. There you go. It's no longer Meredith Vieira. You will forever be known as Tutu LaRue.
I'll be doing some time steps in the next half hour.
Can you still tap dance?
I can. I'll show you. Not right now.
Here. We'll get you
on the hard
surface.
I'll show you another time.
All right. Let's get a check of the weather now from Al.
Tutu LaRue.
Today's weather is brought to you by Kellogg's Special K Cereal. Y'all want to say hi to Meredith? Call her. It's either between that or Tutu LaRue. I like Tutu LaRue. And Tippy Canoe and Tyler, too. So you guys are from Hawaii?
Yeah.
Wow, that's nice. Thanks for coming down and welcoming Meredith. Very nice.
Welcome,
and you're Georgia.
Georgia.
Thank you very much. And aloha from Hawaii. Aloha. Second group. We had a group of Hawaiians here yesterday from Maui.
I know.
Well, we're taking a look right now. This is a tropical depression number 8. Would become Helene if it becomes a storm 225 miles southwest of the southernmost Cape Verde Islands. Moving west at 16, we'll keep an eye on this. Rest of the country, you can see wet weather here in the east. Some of it very heavy down in the panhandle of Florida. Western two-thirds of the U.S. looking pretty good with some hit-or-miss diurnal thunderstorms in the southwest. That's what's going on around the country. Here's what's happening in your neck of the woods.
Another nice day, just not as bright as we have been. A mix of clouds and sunshine out there right now. Norwood 51, in town 54, Beverly at 46. Here are the clouds right here. These are not rainmaking clouds, but over here these are. And with time, I think they will catch up with us overnight tonight and through the day tomorrow. So today we will feature more clouds for you, but it is a dry day from start to finish. Temperatures this afternoon around 70. This evening, cloudy skies cooling off. Temperatures drop back into the mid-50s. Showers for tomorrow.
Meredith.
And thank you, Al. Up next, Deborah LaFave, the former school teacher busted for having a sexual relationship with her middle school student. Why did she do it? The exclusive interview right after this.
There's a prize inside every box of Special K.
Oh, I'm newly calibrated.
Drop up to a jean size when you take the Special K challenge. Replace two meals with two bowls of any delicious Special K variety for 2 weeks. Start today. Take the Special K challenge.
Millions of women who smoke put off quitting for fear of gaining weight. The Commit 4 milligram lozenge can help you gain less weight while you use it to quit smoking.
Almay Ideal Lip Collection. Expertly coordinated lip liner, lipstick, and lip gloss. In pinks, reds, berries, and neutrals. For beautiful lips every time. The Ideal Lip Collection. Only at Almay.
If there were a store in your town called Peace of Mind, would you pay it a visit? Across America, in towns big and small, there is such a place. New York Life. It starts with our values of financial strength, integrity, and humanity, and continues with our agents. So look for us in your town. You may already know our people, and we are confident that peace of mind is why New York Life is the company you keep.
For people with diabetes, testing with Freestyle is virtually pain-free. Freestyle uses the world's smallest blood sample size. And that means happy fingers. Ask your healthcare professional about Freestyle blood glucose monitors.
Part of you wants to learn about menopause. Part of you has no time for research. Visit nomenopause.com. Because part of you wants to understand the hot flashes and moodiness, all of you wants to know more. Check out nomenopause.com.
A million years since graduation.
graduation. 3 days to go back in time. Talbots, what kind of classic are you?
Critics love Studio 60. USA Today calls it the show with a dream cast. Matthew Perry, Bradley Whitford, Amanda Peet, D.L. Hughley.
Stop talking now? Yeah, you bet.
Studio 60 premieres Monday 10, 9 Central on NBC.
We are back at 7:44. School teacher Deborah Lefebvre was arrested in 2004 for having sex with a student at her middle school in a suburb of Tampa, Florida. I sat down with her recently for an exclusive interview in which she told her side of a story that made headlines all around the world.
So why do you think you got all the attention?
I don't know.
I'll say it. Do you think it's because you're pretty?
I think so. And sex sells.
She wasn't the first teacher or the last to be arrested for seducing a student. But Deborah Lefebvre's looks and the sexy photos of her that exploded onto the web made her case an international sensation.
There are some people out there who say this is every 14-year-old boy's fantasy. Did you hear that?
Yeah, I just think it's stupid. I can't even think of any other word to describe it. I think it's ridiculous.
In this, her first ever television interview, Deborah Lefebvre paints a very different picture. She says she was a troubled young woman, plagued by mental illness and by memories of being raped at age 13.
The first time that it happened was in school. He forced me into a bathroom and began to rape me. And a teacher walked in, and she let us off the hook.
Well, you say she let us off the hook. I mean, what did you do wrong? Why did she have to let you off the hook?
Well, she had no clue that I was being raped. You know, she, I'm assuming, just thought we were messing around.
Why didn't you say, this boy's raping me?
It just doesn't happen like that. I had a lot of fear. You know, when somebody has that kind of control over you, especially at 13,
Who was this young man in your life? I mean, was he someone you were close with?
Yeah, he was actually one of my boyfriends.
Deborah says she struggled against depression, phobias, and wild mood swings, but still managed to start a career and marry the man of her dreams. Then, in the spring of 2004, her second year of teaching, she seemed to spiral out of control.
You started smoking, listening to rap music. The teachers and other people have said you started to dress extremely provocatively at school, perhaps inappropriately. Did anyone talk to you?
I just shrugged it off. You know, I felt like for the first time I was confident, and, you know, I was beautiful, and I was going to wear nice clothes and do my makeup and do my hair.
That's interesting, because at the very moment you were standing on the edge of a cliff, basically.
Deborah, age 23, was spending more and more time with a student, age 14. She claims he became flirtatious. As a teacher, she should have known just what to do, but she did the opposite.
As the flirtation continued, and I would imagine at some point here, Debbie, you had to return the flirtation.
Of course.
Looking back, Deborah now says her mental state was deteriorating as her attraction to the boy was growing.
Did you and this student have open conversations about the fact that you two might be getting into very dangerous territory?
You know, there was very little conversation, to be honest with you. You know, looking back, he was 14. You know, what is there really to say to a 23-year-old?
What'd you have in common?
Nothing.
And yet, she was about to take another, much more dangerous step.
At one point, you invited him to your classroom.
Mm-hmm.
And you kissed him.
Yes.
What did you guys say after you kissed?
There wasn't anything to say. It was, at that point, it just turned into a little schoolgirl crush.
A week or so after the classroom kiss, as summer vacation started, the boy was staying at the home of his cousin in Ocala, 100 miles north of Tampa. On June 3rd, while her husband was at work, Deborah drove up there. She picked up the boy and his cousin and took them back to her apartment. They ordered pizza and a movie on pay-per-view. The title, Stuck on You. Then, while the cousin watched TV, Deborah took the boy upstairs to the bedroom.
And what happened there?
Pretty much it was oral sex. Yeah, he wanted it. And yeah, I gave it to him.
10 days later, June 14th, she invited him to help her clean her classroom and crossed yet another line.
And that was the first time.
You had intercourse with him at school?
Yes.
14-year-old boy, very attractive 23-year-old teacher. He's had sex with you. Weren't you scared to death he would tell someone?
Obviously not, because I did it again.
And again.
And again.
Deborah LaFave is currently serving 3 years of house arrest, but she got special permission from a judge to leave home for that interview. And you can see the entire exclusive interview with Deborah LaFave tonight on Dateline. That's at 9, 8 Central Time, right here on NBC. And we'll have part two of that interview tomorrow here on Today. We're back with more of Today right after this.
We got a cop in my crew.
No Wyatt ever, you understand? You don't know what this is like.
I can get the rat. You just let me do it my way.
There was a leak from the inside, man. Smoke him out. What are you waiting for, honestly? You wanted to chop me up and feed me to the poor?
The Departed, a Martin Scorsese picture, rated R.
Something we all know from birth. A woman using sound to bring comfort. And now advanced ultrasound technologies from GE Healthcare are allowing doctors to use the power of sound to change the way they look at women's health. And to a lot of women out there, that's going to sound just beautiful. Healthcare reimagined. GE. Imagination at work.
So fluffy. So soft.
So still being used?
Can't resist big fluffy towels? 3 and 4 star, buy one, get one half off. Only at Kmart.
Research shows that microdermabrasion is a fast and effective way to rejuvenate the look and feel of your skin.
And now there's a way to get professional level results in the best place of all. Your home. Neutrogena Advanced Solutions Microdermabrasion System. Clinical tests show that it's comparable to professional treatment. Skin looks fresher, feels softer. There's a new radiant glow. The look of fine lines, wrinkles, and sun damage are diminished. And it gets better every time I use it. Advanced Solutions Microdermabrasion System. Neutrogena.
No matter what you love, all you need is a Chase Rewards card. Everybody loves to earn free rewards. Find the card you'll love at ChooseChase.com.
Slim Fast Optima Hunger Control Shakes with a unique protein blend to control your hunger up to 4 hours and help you lose weight. Hello, control.
Obviously, it's a big transition for us here at the Today Show. And here at NBC, we have a pretty good track record with transitions. In fact, one guy just made a wildly successful one recently, and he wanted to give you a little welcome.
Oh, Brian.
They're a little wet. Welcome.
So
welcome.
Am I behind the ear.
Please, oh, have a
Brian,
seat. How's it going?
Well, I'm propping him up the best I can.
I was watching, and I love this. I ordered the seaweed wrap and the hot stone massage.
And a California roll?
Yeah, it's great.
It's then, though.
There's one more
then.
Woman to go, and then I can have the hot stone massage. And they said the seaweed wrap would be after lunch, but I'm excited. This whole day has been taken care of by NBC. So you'll love this. Once in a while, takes off his shirt, and it's fun. But this will be a lot of fun. I'm across the way. I work
can look
nights.
You called
Should
me,
we
actually.
Tell
you were
them?
I'm looking in my dressing room.
I'm sitting
from your
in
office.
My office. I'm on the phone. I'm looking out on
please.
49th Street. And across from me, lit up like the break of day, is this woman with just the largest curlers I haven't seen since the late 60s. Looked like a Homeland Security receipt.
I actually am. They're secret weapons.
It was unbelievable. Welcome.
At least I have my clothes on.
Go home and explain the
local
lipstick
news
on
coming
your
up.
You get it?
I don't know. Wish I could have seen your faces.
Here are the heroes of Iwo Jima.
knowing
he was with you that day
and seeing him in that photograph.
I don't know why it makes me feel better, but it does.
It's so silly.
No, it's not.
Flags of Our Fathers starts Friday, October 20th.
Good news, America. Now, wherever you are, there's a Macy's near you. Macy's, way to shop.
It's hard to believe anything could be more natural than this. Introducing Organic Rice Krispies. Childhood is calling.
And now your family can enjoy organic frosted mini wheats and organic raisin bran as well.
Table in only 90 seconds with Uncle Ben's Ready Rice.
Why ask your doctor about Botox Cosmetic?
This is my time.
Everyone has their own reason. Go to BotoxCosmetic.com to find a doctor nearby. Ask your doctor about the one, the only, Botox Cosmetic.
Isn't it about time?
Cancer runs in Lisa Garcia's family. And right now, 8,000 Merck scientists are working to fight cancer and other diseases. Like obesity, heart disease, and Alzheimer's. Merck, where patients come first.
14,000 jobs. That's how many jobs Andrea Silbert helped create as CEO of the nonprofit Center for Women in Enterprise.
My team and I helped 10,000 individuals, and they created 14,000 jobs. We're going to need both the governor and the lieutenant governor going at full steam to turn our economy around.
Andrea Silbert, a plan to use new jobs revenue to improve our public schools and create more middle-class housing.
Jobs is the issue that pays for everything else.
Andrea Silbert, the jobs candidate for lieutenant governor.
This is a time for serious leadership. We need a governor who will bring people together to try new things. A governor who will tell you where he stands. A governor with concrete ideas to make people's lives a little easier. A governor who's not going to promise everything and deliver nothing. A governor who has a proven track record of getting things done. A governor who's going to hold himself accountable. I'm Chris Gabrielli. It shouldn't matter if an idea is Democratic or Republican, as long as it's a good idea that gets results.
This is 7 News Now.
Good morning, 7:57. I'm Jonathan Hall. We'll get you back to the Today Show in a minute. First, Jeremy.
Right now, we are in the upper 40s with partly sunny skies. And for today, more clouds than we have seen, but a little bit milder as well. Temperatures this afternoon, upper 60s to the low 70s. Eventually, the clouds will throw some raindrops at us. Showers tomorrow near 70. A few showers left over on Friday. It's a slow-moving weather system, so even Saturday features clouds to start out the day. But we see sunshine by Saturday afternoon. Sunday, perhaps a beach day.
Sounds good, and here's what's happening. A new poll shows that one Democratic candidate in particular has a substantial lead in the race for governor. This State House News poll shows Deval Patrick has 36% of the vote. Gabrielli comes in second with 26%, and Riley, the attorney general, coming in third, a distant third at 19%, but a pretty small sample there. BU makes a move to sweep the swearing out of sports. A new policy bans the use of swears and derogatory comments at sporting events, especially the hockey games. Those found using foul language in the dog pound will be kicked right out of the venue. As you can imagine, the students don't like it. Meredith and Matt, back after this.
I want real designer names, not made-up ones.
I buy the must-have jeans for prices you never see at the mall. I never have to wait for a sale.
I find new things there every week. Talk
Talk about value.
Talk about value.
TJ Maxx.
TJ Maxx.
TJ Maxx.
Who can help get our state moving again?
Deb Goldberg is my choice for getting our public education system back on the right track.
Deb Goldberg is going to really fight for the accountability of these health insurers.
Deb will do all she can to keep jobs in Massachusetts.
She never backs away.
Deb will work hard for this Commonwealth. The state needs a leader like Deb Goldberg.
I'm Deb Goldberg, and I'm running for Lieutenant Governor. Next Tuesday, I'd appreciate your vote.
Dude, last night I had a dream we went to Friendly's.
We were at Friendly's. Weird. What did we order?
You had honey barbecue chicken, he had buffalo chicken.
Your dream sounds delicious.
Satisfy your cravings with our honey barbecue chicken strips platter, new grilled buffalo chicken platter, or spice it up with our new firecracker barbecue chicken strips platter. All come with a free happy ending sundae.
Was she in your dream?
No, but he was. So come on, get in, get friendly.
Right here, right now. Whenever news happens, wherever the story goes, be the first to know.
Right here, right now.
7 News.
Good luck. I know you're going to be great, so just have a good time.
Mom, keep your chin up. You're going to enjoy it all and have a great time.
Mom, good luck, and please try and relax. I know you're freaked out right now, but please try and relax.
Ben, Gabe, and Lily. Just wishing you well on this first day. I'm sure they're home watching.
Don't freak out.
And another thing, don't mess it up.
You can call
them. We need you to have this gig.
Anyway,
you
we're back.
Go to school later.
We're back at 8 o'clock on the special Wednesday morning, September 13th, 2006. Back inside our newly renovated Studio 1A. I'm Matt Lauer, along with Meredith Vieira and Al Roker. It's a level playing field today, which is nice. It's new and different for you, but it's new and different for us, too, because we're this looking around at a completely new studio.
Are you liking it?
I like it. Yeah, it's going to take some getting used to, but I do like it.
Yeah, it's very sleek, much like yourself.
Hey, we've got monitors everywhere. Will you do me a favor, Meredith? Look in that monitor right there. Yes. I want to show you a little surprise. Take a look at this shot, okay?
That's me.
No.
Oh,
this is the Lincoln School in Providence, Rhode Island. And this is the school where Meredith went to second grade 3 separate times. Actually, not. This is where you went from grammar school all the way through high school.
I went to nursery and started at the age of 2 there.
At Lincoln
and then
School.
I went all the way through 12th grade.
We've got students, we've got teachers, administrators, and we also have a couple of your very best friends there.
I think it's
Amy Quinlan and Chris Hunt, two of your classmates, and they wanted to wish you well. Ladies, everybody, good morning.
Hi, guys.
Good morning.
Good morning, Meredith.
Hi, Meredith.
Hi. I can't believe this.
Hey, Amy, let me start with you because we want the dirt. What was Meredith like in school?
What was she really like?
Yes,
really.
She was very, very sweet. She was incredibly smart, and she was modest because she was beautiful, and she's beautiful today, but she was modest about her looks and her intellect. She never craved attention, but we're not surprised about where she is today. We're so happy for her.
Hey, Chris, what was this chapel committee that Meredith was a part of?
Well, as you probably know, Lincoln School is a Quaker girls' school, and we did have a chapel committee, of which Meredith was the chairman of her senior year. We're all very proud. It was the cool committee.
It was not the cool committee, don't lie.
She was in charge. We're teasing
her. So cool.
It was her job every day to try and pick 2 people to come up and stand in front of the entire school and say something meaningful that we could take with us throughout the day. And she had a tough time doing it. I mean, none of us wanted to get up there and talk. So occasionally she had to fill in. And one day she just panicked and she got up and at this very serene, solemn occasion and started tap dancing.
See, I can tap dance.
She was great.
She can. And she can tap dance.
I want to mention Julia Ilzer, who's the principal of the school. Do we call you a headmistress or a principal at that school?
Well, we call it the head of school, Matt.
All right. I just want to make sure I get the title right.
You get it right, Matt.
Hey, what is this also, the Lamberkin? What is it? Because I understand that's also where the cool girls were, and you were part of that?
No, I wasn't.
Oh,
why
sorry.
Those were the
It was a secret desire.
The Cornells are the Lambertons. Yes. That is true.
They were.
There are a few in the crowd today. Group.
But Meredith, the Today Show is a much better gig than the Lambertons. Don't worry about it.
Well, I want to thank you ladies for being there. And maybe you can just kind of stand aside. I just want some of the students to get a chance to be on camera, too, because I'm sure they want to give a rousing round of applause to their former schoolmate from a long time ago.
Nice.
Not that long.
Yeah, nice.
And right now in the ratings in Providence, we are doing great.
Can I just say something to those students? Because they don't know me, but they're so lucky to be at that school because it is an all-girls school, and people ask me whether that was a great kind of education. But because I went to an all-girls school, I was really empowered. At a time when women weren't being empowered, it is such a great place, and Amy and Chris are such dear, sweet friends. And at the end of the day, if you have your good friends, you have everything.
They got
it all.
They got
bells. And then to have the Today Show is sort of the cherry on the top.
Oh, we have bells? Yeah, they have bells in their hands.
Because that's what those Lambertons did. They rang the bells. Oh. So I'm going to get bells.
Surprise.
I'm going to show them.
All right, ring them and ring them as we. There. Perfect.
Right.
Hey, thank you so much, folks, in Providence at Lincoln School.
Love
we
you.
Appreciate it.
Hi, Mary.
Sweet.
Hey, we got another crowd gathered. Do you want to come for a walk with
I'd
us
love
right
to
now?
Go
come
outside.
On, we're going to go outside because one of the great things about this studio
grab my script.
Over the last, 12 years is that we've been able, after you, Meredith,
thank you.
We've been able to kind of go out and check out right over this way.
Okay.
Go my way out.
Otherwise, you're going to the bathroom. Here, pull this one.
All right.
We've been able to have our friends in our audience at our disposal every morning. Some of the people you know, like Lenny and Einstein, we call them by their first names.
Lenny and Einstein.
Exactly. And the rest of these people.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
Here, can I go first so I can introduce
yes.
you? Do you mind? I'm usually not rude like that, but ladies and gentlemen. People will be in your dressing room for a little gathering after the show.
But they're all coming to lunch afterwards. I wonder, do I look better like this, or do I look better like this?
I look great both ways. Either way.
Anyway, let me tell people what's coming up in this half hour. We kind of teased you. We showed you a little portion of our brand new studio. It's high definition. It's great. It's high tech. And we're going to be showing you around that studio in just a couple of minutes.
And we're down to the last three couples in our wedding competition. One is going to go home today. I'm going to have to say goodbye to them. I'm very upset about that. But then we're going to have an Iron Chef-like competition to determine. Well, we're not going to know who's going to win because eventually the voters will decide in our audience.
What are the rules on that? I mean, what's they basically making a cake?
Why did you say that?
I just want to give the people at home a hint.
It's an Iron Chef-like competition. There could be knives.
Plus the fact that our wedding couples are standing right in front of the cakes over there.
It's a cake. It's just it's a representative.
Okay. Anyway, we've got all that coming up. But first, let's go back inside. Ann Curry's at the news desk with a check of the morning's headlines. Ann?
Hey, it was really fun to see Meredith walk outside. Thanks a lot, Matt and Meredith and Al this morning. Good morning. Good morning once again, everybody. In the news this morning, dramatic images from Southern California today where a wildfire is moving very fast. Burning in the Los Padres National Forest, the fire shut down parts of I-5 near Los Angeles for hours on Tuesday. So far, nearly 25,000 acres are burned and dry, windy conditions are fanning the flames, causing the fire to jump the lines. Today, the military said two U.S. soldiers have been killed in Iraq this week. They died in separate attacks. Also today, Iraqi police discovered the bodies of 65 men who were tortured and shot. There were new deadly attacks in Baghdad this morning. Two car bombs and two mortar attacks killed at least 32 civilians. A fourth terrorist involved in Tuesday's attack on the U.S. Embassy in Damascus died today from his injuries. The other three died in the gun battle with embassy guards. Investigators say all four of the attackers were from Syria. In a closely watched political race, Senator Lincoln Chafee, who voted against the war in Iraq, won his primary in Rhode Island on Tuesday. The moderate Republican faces Democrat Sheldon Whitehouse in November. California Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger signed a bill on Tuesday that will raise the minimum wage in the state to $8 an hour by 2008.
The minimum
California
wage
will now join Massachusetts in having the highest minimum
so
wage
important.
In the nation. The Wall Street Journal is reporting this morning that Ford is thinking about cutting mainly white-collar jobs and benefits by as much as 30% as part of a broader restructuring plan. So far, there is no comment from Ford. And two astronauts stepped into the darkness of space this morning, taking a little spacewalk from the shuttle Atlantis to work on the International Space Station. They are hooking up a rotary joint that will cause solar panels to constantly face the sun as the station circles the Earth. It is now 8:08, and down here on Earth, it's now time for a check of the weather with Al.
Today's weather is brought to you by Visa. Go on, live life. And remember, no matter what it takes, life takes Visa.
And this lady's been complaining. I've been standing in front of you. See, now, if I didn't... Oh, she's going to just launch into a whole shit. Are you with her?
Not right now.
You guys from New Orleans?
Yeah, we're from New Orleans.
What are you doing here?
Visiting.
Visiting?
Yeah. She came from Meredith.
Oh, you came from Meredith?
Yeah, and you?
Duh. And where are you ladies from?
Lisa Evans from Piscataway.
See, she's giving her whole name. She is it. Right. No. No, you had your chance. You had your chance. No. Hi, Mom. How are you?
I'm good.
Thanks for coming, ladies. Let's check your weather, see what's going on. We'll show you for today our pick city, Omaha, Nebraska. Sunshine, warm, 84 degrees. Rest of the country, we've got rain in the eastern half of the U.S. Strong storms bringing up to 3 to 5 inches of rain in Florida. Lots of sunshine out west. Clouds in the Pacific Northwest. Heat continues Texas on into the southwest and all the way up into the mid-plains. That's what's going on around the country. Here's what's happening in your neck of the woods.
Well, we do have a few more clouds out there today, but these are thin and wimpy clouds, not really able to block out the sunshine, certainly not producing any raindrops. The rainmakers, they're over here, and I know it looks relatively close, but they're going to stay out to our west throughout the day. So not as bright as we have been, but still a dry day. Temperatures today, upper 60s to the low 70s. And as we look toward tomorrow, cloudy skies, showers develop. Temperatures tomorrow, upper 60s to the low 70s. As we get toward tomorrow, showers linger through Friday, sunshine by the weekend.
And now back to Ms. Vieira.
Thank you, great one. Well, up next, Home Sweet Home, a guided tour of our new and improved Studio 1A, right after this.
But Trent, are we going back in? Is it?
Looking for something.
Where's the gold?
I got tired of people taking it. So I got a Visa check card. And if this gets stolen, I'm not liable for any fraudulent charges. And I get all that money back.
Give me it.
No.
Give me the card.
No. Oh, look, a unicorn.
The Visa check card. Safer, better money. Life takes Visa.
Babe Ruth's bat is missing. You're fired.
A kid who set out to save his family.
I have to do this for my dad.
Will become a hero.
Bingo.
To an entire city.
How about that kid, huh?
Everyone's hero, rated G.
Why not put some "Mama, you look pretty today" in your cart? Say yes to beautiful without paying the price. Suave.
Brands designed for the way you live. Now you can find them only at a Macy's near you. Macy's, way to shop.
Our show was in half an hour.
But with my allergies, I wasn't all there. So I got Claritin Clear. Claritin D relieved my worst symptoms, even my congestion, and I wasn't drowsy.
Nothing works stronger, faster, or longer.
Live Claritin Clear.
We seek it out. A miracle food that nourishes the mind and body. We call it the egg.
You may remember my embarrassing dinner meeting. I no longer suffer with painful, loose-fitting dentures. With my permanent Nobel smile implants, I can eat whatever I want, and I can taste it, too. The dinner did have one great outcome. I met my beautiful wife.
Together, we found a Nobel smile dentist who not only restored my husband's missing teeth, but also gave me beautiful, natural-looking Procera crowns. To find your Nobel Smile Dentist, call 1-877-MY-NOBEL. What are you waiting for?
Mm-hmm.
intelligent to be categorized. The RAV4 from Toyota.
We've come to Europe in search of answers. How was an entire city built on water? How could one man have given us the David and the Sistine Chapel? But more importantly, do those come in my size? This isn't a vacation, it's an adventure. Find out how to create yours at RoyalCaribbean.com and get out there.
You know, it was really important for us to debut not only you today, but also a brand new studio. And crews have been working around the clock, 24/7, for months to accomplish this morning. And before we give you a little tour, and we'll do that over the next couple of days, Al's going to take us for a look back at how this all came together.
...7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and here is Dave Garrell.
Well, here we are. Good morning to you.
Today, Thursday, March the 2nd.
Good morning, this is Today.
Good morning, all. I'm Tom Brokaw, Jane Pauley, Lord Scott.
Over the past 54 years, we've beamed into your living rooms from a variety of studios.
This is really a working news center.
Pushing the bounds of technology.
This is a fantastic machine. If you can get real close to it, it just sounds like a machine gun.
From black and white to color, film to video, and now high definition. We've changed with the times, and our new studio's no exception.
This is going to be our state-of-the-art high-definition control room. Now, last time we did this, we said it was state-of-the-art, but we really mean it this time.
A team of hundreds spent the last 8 months redesigning this space. It's a TV command center that coordinates 4 anchors, 12 cameras, and satellite feeds from around the world.
Also ahead,
while we broadcast from our plaza this summer, we had just 3 months to transform the studio. That's pretty impressive when you think the last time we renovated in 1994, it took over a year.
Does that say today?
Designer Jeremy Conway has created sets for feature films and television shows like Sex in the City.
We're going to lighten the whole thing up, basically chuck all the furniture. Then, because it's high definition, we also intend to use a lot of glass, transparent panels, gauzes, screens, which will really enhance the high-def viewing experience.
This is our green room where all our guests hang out. We have cooks, kids, actors, and as you can see, they have to squeeze into a pretty tight space.
Now our guests will relax in style.
So good.
How are you?
And as for the stars,
VIP, this is a closet right now, but eventually they're going to be blowing this wall out and it's going to be a VIP dressing room. So many of our VIPs will be coming out of the closet.
They spent millions spiffing up the joint. Now, I'm not one to complain. However,
one of the worst parts about our studio is the elevator. It's the smallest, slowest elevator in the city. And it's not going to get changed. It's a little tight in here, huh?
From the floorboards to the roof, we may look a bit different, but rest assured, the more things change, the more what's important stays the same.
We are in touch with the world. We'll tell you what's happening today.
And you know what? Hats off to the technical people and the stage people who did an amazing job in a short amount of time getting us ready for today. We appreciate it. We'll show you around as we continue over the next couple of days. But first, these messages.
Does a promise come with an expiration date? Is it good for a month, a year, or decades from now? At New York Life, we make promises that have no expiration date. Promises that are built on the timeless values of financial strength, integrity, and humanity. Promises that we live by. So no matter how the world changes around you, New York Life is the company you keep.
You know, FedEx gave us solutions for all our domestic shipping needs. Maybe we should go international.
Well, FedEx has been in China for over 20 years.
Hey, Bill, put a pushpin in China. Bill, it's Russia. That's Greenland, Bill. You have no idea where China is, do you?
Whoa!
FedEx, shipping to over 200 cities in China.
All of us have internal plumbing. But for some of us with frequent bladder urges,
Doing errands also means knowing where all the bathrooms are along the way. The worry your pipes might leak means you don't always detour from your route. But you can take another direction. Talk to your doctor about how to take care with Vesicare. Vesicare, once a day, can reduce urges and may help effectively manage bladder leakage day and night. If you have certain types of stomach, urinary, or glaucoma problems, do not take Vesicare. While taking Vesicare, if you experience a serious allergic reaction, severe abdominal pain, or become constipated for 3 or more days, tell your doctor right away. Common side effects are dry mouth, constipation, blurred vision, and indigestion. A chance to follow a whim, not always your urges. It's not just a pipe dream. Ask your doctor today if Vesicare is right for you.
David's Bridal announces the $99 gown sale. Beautiful gowns starting at just $99, and every gown $50 to $200 off. Plus, pay no interest and no payments for 6 months. Hurry, sale ends September 25th.
Studies suggest that people who drink milk regularly tend to weigh less and have less body fat than those who don't. So drink 24 ounces of low-fat or fat-free milk every 24 hours as part of your reduced calorie diet. Just one more reason milk is good for you. Milk your diet. Lose weight. For more on the science, visit 2424milk.com.
What's up for lunch?
I thought I'd go scavenge for bagels in the conference room.
Hey, what are you having?
A crispy crust pizza with grilled chicken, roasted garlic, onions, and mozzarella cheese. It's one of those brick oven-style pizzas from Lean Cuisine.
Today, Throws a Wedding is brought to you by Stouffer's Lean Cuisine. Do something good for yourself. So it's your wedding day,
and my music starts to play. And this morning on Today, Throws a Wedding, we're wrapping up a 7-week-long competition with all of our couples vying for a chance to get married right here on the Today Show in a live event. So before we go any further, let's reintroduce the Fantastic Three, shall we? We have Shantae and Joshua from Richmond, Virginia. We have Christine and Eric from Tampa, Florida. And we have Molly and Jason from Playa del Rey, California.
And I have spent the past few weeks watching you guys sing and dance and model clothes and go shopping and run and jump and do all that stuff. And I love you all, but unfortunately, one couple is going to have to leave today. The stakes are very, very high, so we're going to find out who gets to stay.
And it's very hard for us to always to say goodbye to someone, and that's why we decided Meredith would do it today on her first day.
Short straw.
But let's just remind people, Molly and Jason, all right, you guys want immunity after our wedding-themed obstacle course, so you're safe. You're in the final competition, which has got to be great. You're automatically included. So we have your chef's hats somewhere. Do we have those, the chef's hats? Where are they? Over there. Okay. Okay, great. Bring those over, please, Donna.
I'll get them.
Come on. You can give them to them. You're in. Congratulations. That means that the race is now on between Virginia and Florida, Shantae and Joshua, and Christine and Eric. So, Molly and Jason, this wedding cake has one more set of hats inside, and the names of the final competitors will be on those hats. So, if you would, please walk over and open the cake and tell us who it'll be.
Shantae and Joshua,
congratulations.
Congratulations, you guys. You have to put on your hats now.
Christine and Eric.
There you go.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Christine.
Thank you so much. It's been great having you here. It really is. Thank you. Been great competitors. Before we go any further, let's get to know our remaining couples a little better.
Throughout this competition, I think what America hasn't gotten a chance to see about Jason is just his incredibly supportive side. And I just know that he's the kind of person that will be there for me forever.
What America hasn't had the opportunity to learn about Molly is that she is such a nurturing, gracious, loving person.
I've been asked so many times, why do I want to get married on national TV? Is just that I lost my mom, and every time I got started in the planning process, the grieving process was really quick to follow. When we started hearing on the Today Show they were having this competition, I thought, if I can't have my mom, it would be so amazing to have America help us plan our wedding and pick everything out and be there for us. We hope to get your votes and share an amazing experience with you and really let you see our love story.
I think the one thing that I would like America to know is that, you know, we love each other so much. It doesn't matter what the score may say. We just have a lot of fun with each other, and that, you know, we're just so excited about starting our life together. And that we found each other is just the most amazing reward we could ever get.
We're really just proud of our love and want them to see that it doesn't really matter about color. It's really about the person. And more than anything, we're people who love each other, regardless of what people may see.
America, thank you for letting us get this far. We're just so excited. And no matter who you pick, we've just had an amazing time.
But we're just so happy that we were able to share ourselves, our silliness, and our love with you guys over the past few weeks. Thank you, and we've had a blast. Bye.
And we are down to two couples. One of you is going to end up getting married here on the Today Show in October. How are you all feeling right now, Molly and Jason?
Excited. I mean,
yeah,
just
we can't
thrilled.
Wait.
And Shantae and Joshua, a little butterflies? Or?
We're excited. We're excited to see Eric and Christine go. We make good friends with them.
I can tell.
We want to invite them to the wedding no matter what happens.
That's lovely. Okay, that's a deal.
That's great. Well, get ready because, as you know, we've got some kind of an Iron Chef-like competition coming up. There's always a secret ingredient. We're not going to tell you what that is until after a commercial break. And when we come back, Shantae and Joshua and Molly and Jason go head-to-head in a cooking kind of competition right here on our plaza, and you're going to get to decide who gets married right here on Today.
Friday on Today, Black Eyed Peas with Fergie. Delicious. In a special performance, live on the plaza, only on Today on NBC.
14,000 jobs. That's how many jobs Andrea Silbert helped create as CEO of the nonprofit Center for Women in Enterprise.
We're going to need both the governor and the lieutenant governor going at full steam to turn our economy around.
Andrea Silbert, a plan to use new jobs revenue to improve our public schools and create more middle-class housing.
Jobs is the issue that pays for everything else.
Andrea Silbert, the jobs candidate for lieutenant governor.
Paid for by the committee to elect Andrea Silbert.
Southern Healthcast with Dr. Deanna Lice. Hot Health Topics with the Hub's top docs.
There's a rapid growth period.
Self-relaxation, physical therapy.
Do self-rest exams.
It's your link to the best
specialists, hospitals, breakthroughs, experts.
You've got medical questions, Deanna's got answers. When there's new information, we'll make sure you know about it. Make an appointment with Dr. Deanna Lice and Southern Healthcast. Weekdays on the news station, 7 News. This is 7 News.
Good Wednesday morning, 8:27. I'm Krista Delkamp. 56 degrees here in Boston. And Jeremy, where's the temperature going today?
Well, we're heading up into the upper 60s and the low 70s. Out there right now, we do have a few clouds out there, and we're going to see a few more clouds throughout the day. But the rainmaking clouds, they will stay to our west, eventually catching up with us tomorrow. Out there this afternoon, upper 60s to the low 70s, probably right around 70 here in the city. Now for tomorrow, cloudy skies, showers develop late tomorrow morning and go on and off through the afternoon. In fact, this next weather system moving in is a slow mover. So I think even as we head toward Friday, some showers still in the forecast. But for the weekend, we dry it out and warm it up.
All right, Jeremy, thank you. In Saugus, pets have been disappearing and coyotes are actually suspected. 17 cats have gone missing this year, including this one. So far, no one has found any remains or seen suspicious activity, but most of the cats have gone missing near more rural areas where coyotes were occasionally spotted. Animal control officers point out that coyotes have been known to kill pets and then bury the carcasses. They say that coyote encounters become more common this time of year because the mothers are teaching their young to hunt. Boston's new Filene's Basement store opening up today. The store is located in the Back Bay by Boylston and Newbury Streets. Gone is the no-frills style of the original basement store. The new one features a few upscale touches. The original store, by the way, at Downtown Crossing opened back in 1908. Now back to the Today Show in New York.
This is a time for serious leadership. We need a governor who will bring people together to try new things. A governor who will tell you where he stands. A governor with concrete ideas to make people's lives a little easier. A governor who's not going to promise everything and deliver nothing. A governor who has a proven track record of getting things done. A governor who's going to hold himself accountable. I'm Chris Gabrielli. It shouldn't matter if an idea is Democratic or Republican, as long as it's a good idea that gets results.
Critics are calling The Last Kiss a very sexy movie that's funny and insightful.
How intense is that?
Very intense.
Two thumbs up.
You are an enormous loser.
Only a loser could love a loser.
The Last Kiss, rated R, starts Friday.
We're facing tough challenges in Massachusetts. And what has Carrie Healy done? Healy has abused her position, using state employees to staff her political events and state police escorts to avoid traffic. Healy opposed property tax relief for seniors. She said they were, quote, overhoused. And Healy and Romney even tried to cut millions from public education. Carrie Healy just doesn't get it.
All the King's Men is a masterpiece.
Your will is my strength.
Sean Penn gives the performance of a lifetime.
They want to ruin you.
And I won't let them!
All the King's Men, rated PG-13.
Tonight, Jay's all new with Studio 60's Matthew Perry, Outkast, and Internet Bargains.
Britney Spears, infant bubble wrap. Yeah, this thing.
And on Conan, Ashton Kutcher, and 30 Rock's Tracy Morgan.
And it's 8:30 now on this Wednesday morning, the 13th of September, 2006. Crowded out here on the corner of Rockefeller Plaza and 49th Street. Lots of folks joining me on my first day. Thanks for coming out, you guys.
I am Meredith Vieira. I only got to see that move.
I have that white girl dancing going
down.
I'm here with the really mean Al Roker and Matt Lauer, and it is a big day. Ready, set, start your ovens. The finales of Today Throws a Wedding. Right, we're down to two couples. And they're going to make something. It's an Iron Chef-style competition. They don't know what they're making. I don't believe there are sharp knives involved. I pray there aren't.
No, there
but they seem pretty calm.
No, and they got a cool setup. I mean, I'm not exactly sure what the secret ingredient is just yet. Actually, I know exactly what
yeah,
they
exactly.
don't know. They're going to find that in a second. And at the end of the competition, we have to, we get to taste what they have created.
Oh, no.
So that'll be a lot of fun. But before we get to that, since you're joining our family today,
yes, I am.
I wanted to introduce you to two of the most beloved members of this extended family. Between them, 59 years on the Today Show.
Oh, I know.
So Willard Scott and Gene Shalit have come on up to say good morning to you.
Nice
how are you?
Both.
Good to
now
see you.
This is the view I've been looking for.
Are you ready?
Follow the
yellow brick road.
No, don't take her yet. Don't take her yet. Guys,
that's it. Knock it off.
Bring her back.
Want to go back to ABC?
Any advice for Meredith? I mean, you've been here, as I said, 59 years between the two of you. Any advice for her on her
He's
first
been
day?
Here 58, and I've been here once.
Works out. Come in the work the night shift. Come in the back door and stay off the second floor.
Oh, okay. What's on the second floor?
The guys.
Can I tell you, these two are the litmus test. If they like you, you're going to do really well here because...
We like you.
Thank you.
They get it more than anyone else. They really do. And after
Not
you,
often.
And after you...
Enough.
After you've met them, you'll know why we hide the cough syrup and the rubbing alcohol around here. Guys, thanks very much.
We really want to welcome you. We're very, very excited to be on the same show with you.
I'm honored to be on the same show with you guys. Thank
you. You look like a million.
Thank you. There you go, a million.
Actually, 14 million. But I wanted you to have my rose.
I got it.
There you go.
Now smells good.
Now my nose.
You should be on the stage, Willard. And there's one leaving in about 15 minutes.
This is what Carl killed vaudeville.
Let's get a check of the weather from you.
Thank you.
All right, from you. We'll show you for right now. We're basically talking about a gorgeous day in the western two-thirds of the country. A lot of rain, low pressure from the Great Lakes all the way down into Florida with some rain there. And the rain moves into the northeast full-time later on tomorrow. We've got cooler conditions back through the northwest, hot weather from the plains all the way down into Texas. That's what's going on around the country. Here's what's happening in your neck of the woods.
We do have another nice day on the way, just not as bright as we have been. Mix of clouds and sunshine right now as we look farther west. Here's the next storm system taking shape. It's not that far away, but it's having a hard time moving into New England, which means it'll have a hard time getting out of here in a few days. So today is a nice one. Enjoy it. Upper 60s to the low 70s. Tomorrow does feature more clouds. Showers developing late tomorrow morning, on and off through the afternoon. And temperatures tomorrow, upper 60s to the low 70s.
All right, that's your latest weather. And now it's time, Meredith, this is your first experience of Willard Scott and the 100-year-old birthday.
Hey! And just think, in 72 years, I can wish you a happy one.
Thank you so much, Willard.
I'll bring you some Smuckers right after. I think we should all participate. Annie Dinkins, who is your wife, Deborah's aunt,
that's right? That's right, Deborah's aunt.
Annie Dinkins is 100 years old today.
Where's she from?
She's from Perry, Georgia, one of the great states in the Union. My grandson lives in Georgia. Still goes to New Hope Baptist Church and is known for her peanut butter cake. Al, would you testify to that?
It is the best peanut butter cake in America.
That's enough. Don't go crazy.
Sorry.
And now this is Marco Condi of Andover, New York, right? Would you like to do a little shot there?
Andover, New York. Andover and over and over.
Read the
She was a school teacher and librarian for over 40 years. Recently honored in her hometown, 4th of July parade, as a town treasurer.
That's right. Now she's going into politics, and we won't say which party. Florence Kerrigan of?
It's either Mundelein or Mendeline or Mundaloon, Illinois.
You're pretty sure she lives in Illinois.
Which town is it?
Champaign or Banner.
Mundaline, she said.
Mundaline.
I didn't ask for a diatribe. I just want to pronounce the age.
Can you pronounce this? Years old.
That's right, 103.
103.
Still lives in her own house, loves to travel, bakes from scratch.
She has an itch.
Named Woman of the Year by her church group.
Famous oatmeal cookie.
That's right, always.
Okay, who's next?
Dale Fry, Garden City, Kansas.
100 years old.
Manufactured farm equipment, lives on his own farm, and enjoys visits from his old cronies.
He has three great-grandsons serving military tours in Iraq.
God bless.
God bless them.
God bless. And Marie Williams, Little Rock, Arkansas, is 102 years old today.
She worked in a doctor's office until she got... She was 95 and drove until she was 97.
And she's still out there somewhere on the Pennsylvania Turnpike.
Very good doctor.
There you go, doctor. I have a
What's
patient.
His name?
Valentine Mathis.
Hello.
Iowa.
100.
You heard of the famous Iowa Windows?
Yeah, that's Pella Windows.
Anyway, he's the oldest of nine siblings and also children.
The news would be if he was the youngest of nine siblings.
There you have it.
He's incredible. That's a handsome man for 100.
Willard and Gene.
Look at that.
Thank you guys
and
very much.
And they'll be in the Poconos next week.
Us or those guys?
Just ignore him. Up next up today, the wedding cook-off. And first, this is today on NBC. I'll get this down.
And it's raining.
Babe Ruth's bat is missing.
It was your shift.
You're fired.
This Friday.
I have to do this for my dad.
A kid who set out to save his family.
Whoa! Whoa, so far, so good.
Will become a hero.
Uh-oh. Hey, yo!
To an entire city.
I've got to get Baby's bat back.
William H. Macy. Rob Reiner.
My head, my butt.
Raven Simone.
Yeah!
And Whoopi Goldberg.
Don't you make me break out my whooping stick.
Everyone's hero. Rated G.
How about that, kid, huh?
Friday, only in theaters.
When we began this campaign, the insiders on Beacon Hill were laughing. They didn't believe you could change politics as usual in Massachusetts. Well, they're not laughing anymore. They're worried, and they're responding just as you'd expect, with misleading negative ads. All I've said on taxes is the truth. If we cut the income tax now, your property taxes will go up. It's a shell game, and we can't afford it. Insider politics and negative ads won't lift our state, but on Election Day, we can.
This is Doug, calculating, patient, and true Toyota clearance shopper. He waited for Toyota's clearance deals. He knows he could save, and now he's going for it. Toyota's last chance clearance is on. You could lease a Tundra double cab for just $199 a month for 36 months with only $22.99 due at signing. Toyota's last chance clearance ends October 2nd. Go for it, and you won't miss your chance to save. Toyota, moving forward.
Need new shoes? With 40,000 pairs of your favorite designer brands at warehouse prices every day, we've got the shoes for you. Off-Broadway Shoe Warehouse, In New Hampshire, Salem and Manchester. In Massachusetts, Burlington and Plymouth.
And we are back now with Today Throws a Wedding. In case you missed it, we have just announced our final two couples competing for a wedding right here on the Today Show. And they are Molly and Jason from Playa del Rey, California, and Shantae and Joshua from Richmond, Virginia.
So we have our couples, but like most Iron Chef competitions, we need a secret ingredient. And our secret ingredient, Al Roker, is here with the details.
You're cooking with me, huh?
They certainly are.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the challenge for you is to design a cake. But not just any cake, a wedding cake that is a reflection of you as a couple. So, let's reveal our secret ingredient. You will find, at 5 minutes for this competition, you'll find almost any item you would need or here in your pantry. When your time's up, you're going to present and describe your cake. One final note, there will not be immunity for this challenge. This is your final opportunity to impress our viewers. And to help us along today, Anne, you're going to introduce our VIP.
That's right, because we're going to give you a little inspiration this morning. So to do that, we've asked Anthony Walton, the executive chef of the Boathouse in Central Park, to stop by this morning. Good morning. It's nice to see you. We want to tell people that the Boathouse in Central Park is a quintessential spot in New York City. It's basically a perfect place for a party, an intimate dinner, or a celebration of a wedding. And in fact, we're thrilled to announce this morning that on October 6th, your wedding day, the Boathouse will be the picturesque location for our Today Throws a Wedding reception. So yay about that.
What do you think?
All right. So what do you think? You're clapping your hands because you know it's going to be pretty.
I know it's great. We have a lovely setting, whether it's winter, spring, summer, fall, we're coming with the fall, the leaves change. You have the beautiful picture of the lake and the park and the Bethesda Fountain. Then we take a la carte dining, we give it to you in a beautiful catered atmosphere. So it's a win-win situation.
Yeah, and you've also got the roof, so
we've
in case
done a lot of
weather issues, you know, you're
right,
there.
Restoration,
but it's so beautiful the way that light is. Thanks a lot,
Thank
Anthony.
You.
Okay, all right, we jazz?
All right.
Okay.
Okay, couples, now remember, our secret ingredient is cake. You're going to have 5 minutes to create a cake that reflects you both as couples. Then the viewers are going to vote on the winner. Let's put 5 minutes on the clock, please. All righty. You guys ready?
I'm getting out of the way.
On your mark. Get set. Go!
Let's get the big hold on. Al, I want to tell you that Molly and Jason, the minute you revealed the secret ingredient, they started consulting with each other.
Uh-oh.
And they were talking about their game plan.
Well, these are already iced cakes. They're simple vanilla cakes with jelly in between the layers. Obviously, different sizes.
All right, why don't you start with
it? Everybody's going for the rectangular right now. They've got a number of items they can take part in. They've got icing. They've got different jelly beans, silver balls, flowers. Very lovely.
Yeah, three different kinds of icing. Right. Jason was already sampling some of that, by the way.
I'm sorry.
Meredith, are you a very good cook over here?
I am. Did you listen to my kids earlier? I do not know how to cook.
Joshua is actually already cutting up cake.
He's hungry.
I'm hungry. I just wanted to bite it. It's really good.
Well, you guys are lousy cooks, aren't you?
We're terrible. Like, pretty lousy. The worst.
Meredith?
The worst.
Do they know that there are other ingredients?
Oh, yeah, you can put
behind?
All these little beads and stuff
on.
Oh,
really? Oh, great. Cut your personality.
Great.
I will keep it short.
Remember, you got engaged in Japan, right? So
exactly.
I don't know if there's any kind of
Pokemon.
There you go.
Pokemon. You got that right there?
Pokemon?
I got the Pokemon here.
Okay.
I'm going to work on that bottom
what
part,
are you
right?
doing? What are you doing?
I got the pieces cut.
Okay.
That's interesting.
Kind of the logs.
Okay, I like the logs.
So,
you know what you really thought about the way Molly and
Jay are you cutting it all? Is that Molly?
I'm not quite sure yet, but I'll figure it out at some point in time. And all will kind of come together. Right here.
You know, Jason, you actually consulted right with your brother for the cooking competition. Why?
Here we go.
Okay, we go. Put that right there.
Nice.
All right, you continue working on the green.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay, and as it turns out, you don't get to use any of that.
Get the flowers on this level.
It's always filled up.
Okay, we got the flowers.
Yeah, tell us what to do with the flowers.
How's your couple doing?
My couple's doing very well. Why are you putting that? Is there a significance to the flowers?
There's going to be significance to the flowers.
There is going to be a school fire,
I imagine.
What's the significance of taking apart that cake?
You'll see.
I'm
you'll see. Never question an artist, Al. Never question an artist.
Oh, wait. Oh, I know. Here we go.
Right in.
You've got to prop that thing up. So we're going to
start. Okay, we've got just under 3 minutes left on the clock. 2 minutes and 45 seconds now.
We're seeing hearts, which is very lovely, romantic.
Absolutely.
I'm getting that sense.
Chef Anthony, what do you see so far? What's impressed you?
I see the fact that we're going with a more traditional style with the layered cake and the tears, and a little bit more of a, this is us, this is who we are, we've come here, and we're going to win.
What do you think this says? What do you think Molly and Jason's cake says?
We have a West Coast, East Coast theme going here.
Really?
Definitely representative for each lifestyle.
I like these. Molly and Jason, you can get the star.
They're doing their life.
No, you are an actress, Shantae, so that's probably your dancer, performer.
Okay. What does this tree represent?
This is the bottom level. This is the
2 minutes left, everybody. 2 minutes. Okay.
2 minute warning.
Would you actually want this cake at your wedding?
Why not? You know,
I don't think so.
Maybe a few other cakes. Maybe a few other ones. Why not?
Okay. Molly and Jason over here, you guys got immunity for the first time last week. Do you think it made you a little cocky coming into the final competition?
No, not at all. We've worked as hard to get votes as we ever have. So we've got a stiff competition. So
I think you're
got a minute and a half now.
Okay.
A minute and a half, everybody.
You don't have a lot of time. How much?
A minute and a half
to go.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, we won't worry about it.
This is for the clouds, right?
Yeah, the clouds up here.
No, we don't. The clouds are up here?
Yeah.
What are the clouds representing? Oh, because you're going from the ground up.
Right, we're going from the ground up.
Do you see anybody here you might hire as a pastry chef?
Right.
Most certainly not. But someone who would like to invite us for dinner.
Okay,
so
you know, it's interesting to see how everybody's working. You know, there's a lot of discussion.
Well, I'm very impressed.
Coming up in a minute. Coming up, we do
1 minute.
They're working like a real couple. That will stop once they're married.
You know, major challenges in life.
No, we have this cooperating stuff. They'll be at each other's throats.
I like this.
Let's be honest with them.
But it's not. It's in the wrist. Very nice.
Yeah, I know. Life isn't easy, and neither is making a cake and decorating it.
I'm sorry.
All right, folks, coming up in 30 seconds.